Hello, welcome to the Daily Sporran. Today I'm going to do a part of Thick as a Brick called The Poet and the Painter on the middle of side one. It's a bit of Thick as a Brick, which is about the life of action versus the life of contemplation. And it's seen through the eyes of Gerald Bostock, the young boy. He's trying to work out which parts of what he's told as a young man are rubbish and which parts are worth listening to. It's a really strong, challenging musical section. This, I really like it. I hope you enjoy it. As the sun plays on the infantry returning from the sea, the doer and the thinker, no allowance for the other, as the fading light illuminates the mercenary's creep, the home fire burning, the kettle almost boiling, but the master of the house is far away. Morning of the day, and the poet lifts his pen while the soldier sheathes his sword, and the youngest of the family is moving with authority, a building castles by the sea. He dares the tardy tide to wash them all aside.
Contemplates the milking girl whose offer is his need. The young men of the household have all gone into service and are not to be expected for a year. The innocent young master, thoughts moving ever faster, has formed the plan to change the man he sees. And the poet sheets his while the soldier lifts his sword. And the oldest of the family is moving with authority, coming from across the sea. He challenges the sun to put into the run.
Thank you.
way of being.
I hope you liked, or didn't dislike at least, the compressed instrumental bit in the middle. I thought that would test your patience if I did the whole thing. All right, thanks very much. See you soon.